Hello makeup fiends, and today I apologise for the flat looking dark hair. Lighting's very funny in here today, but I'm filming my what I got for Christmas video. I hate these disclaimer parts that you have to feel like you have to do, but I'm not showing off. I don't have huge amounts. It's not like somebody bought me a Ferrari or anything like that. Would be stupid because I can't drive, but never mind. But yeah, this is what I got for Christmas, and I really love watching these videos, so I want to share what I got. So I'll start with what I got off my mum and dad, because that's what comes to hand first. They always get me now a bar of my favorite soap. This is the L'Occitane milk soap. Now this is a huge bar of soap. It's about £7.50, so this is expensive soap. But this bar of soap will last approximately 6 months. I go through two of these a year, so it lasts about 6 months. I use it every single day, and I use it on my body, and I also use it on my face. So it does last a long time. I do have one open, but I will open it and just show you it, because I can just pop it back in its wrapping and pop it back in the drawer. Not that there's anything much to see, because it's just soap, but that's what it looks like. And I just love it. I love the milk range from L'Occitane. It smells amazing. And I really, I'm a huge fan of milk products, particularly if you have oily skin, because this is something that Cleopatra used to use. She was very into using milk because it actually like helps control the oil, kind of breaks the oil down and cuts through it. And it's actually very gentle and moisturizing. So there you go. That's what I think about that soap. Sorry, I came a bit close there. The next thing they got me, well, actually they got me a book, but my mum kind of warned me about it before I opened it because we obviously lost Millie. You would have seen that video, so I don't want to go into talking about it because it's just still something I can't talk about. But it was a book that a man had written. He's a dog owner, and he'd written it from the dog's perspective, and he was signing them in W.H. Smith's, and he signed it with a dedication. So my mum kind of said, don't read the dedication in this one, because obviously it was only 3 days prior. She says, you know, just look at it when you're ready. So I kind of opened it and I just popped it in my bag. I didn't even look at it. So that is downstairs, and I will look at that at some point. I don't normally read those kind of things because they usually get me upset and crying. Anyway, and that's without the loss of a baby, a fairy baby. So yeah, that's downstairs, and I will get to that at some point. I will show you it when I do, but I'm just not ready yet. So that, she got me that, and then they got me the scarf. This is from a place in York, I don't know where, but it's absolutely mahoosive. I don't know if you can see how wide that is, and then it's really, really long. They actually bought me one of these before, and it was the dark grey. So they wanted to get me like sort of the light grey, almost white colour, which is just probably just a bit more sort of spring summery than the other one, which is dark grey. And I absolutely love the other one and love wearing it. And I'm a huge Marilyn Monroe fan, so I love that. They also got me a necklace. This is by Pia, which is somebody I've never heard of before. I think that I'm not sure. My mum goes to this place in York where they sell a lot of like Lola Rose and that kind of jewellery. And I think that she found it while she was in there. And it comes in here with this sort of velvet, sort of protective packaging over it. And then it came with like its own little card, which kind of tells you how to care for it and like what it's made of and stuff like that. It's actually made of like semi-precious stones, and it's quite long. And it's just kind of those taupey sort of colours and smoky blacks and greys, which are really great to wear like with neutral clothing. I don't know if you can hear it clanking together. It's really, really heavy necklace. I actually wore that on Christmas Day when I got it. It's lovely. So yeah, they got me that instead of Lola Rose, because I normally get a piece of Lola Rose every year, but my mum's kind of gone off Lola Rose a little bit lately. She doesn't feel like the quality's quite the same, and the designs are just not quite as nice as they used to be, and they're not made quite the same. So she got me this instead. So I really love that. They gave me a box, like sort of a plastic box of Quality Street, which is downstairs. I only eat the strawberries and oranges, so I've already consumed the strawberries and oranges out of the Quality Street, and the box is now downstairs for Alec to work his way through, because I don't use that. I don't eat, I don't like anything but the soft centers. So, yeah. And then the last thing they gave me was this purse. It's a Radley purse. And she's given me one before that was really quite long, and I like it, but I don't tend to use it a lot because I'm not a bag and purse kind of person. I really like something that's a bit more carryable. I can put it in my pocket or an inside pocket or a small handbag because I'm just not a handbag kind of girl. I'm not your average girly girl. So they got me this purse, which is actually a really nice size, and it's got these like sort of Scotty dogs on there, and they're wearing like the what the guards wear at Buckingham Palace, and they're kind of marching. And then she always puts a piece of silver in because you're supposed to put silver into a purse. So there's 50 pence in there because it's bad luck to give a purse and not put silver in it, which is kind of, you know, an old tradition. And then there is some money in there. So I have spending money, which was kind of like our main thing, our main present really. Or my main present was to give me some money that I could go out shopping with. So that's quite nice. I'm just going to save that. And that was it, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was it from my mum and dad. And then moving on to things from like Alec and Tony. They're a bit mixed up because this is the way I've got them stacked. So please bear with me. My hair looks so flat.
Ew.
Today. What?
Ew.
Ew, says Tony. Oh, the other thing that my mum and dad got me was this onesie, which is what I'm wearing. Sorry, I'm shaking my boobs at you. This is, it's got ears, kind of like Wendy's ears. And it's so cute and it's so cosy. This one's from Sainsbury's and I think it had originally been £18. And then it had gone down, obviously, half price, which was £9. And then they had a 15 or 20% off. So she ended up getting it for, I don't know, £7 or £8. And this is what she got me. Alec got one in blue. It's actually his as a woman's one, but it doesn't matter because it's navy blue. And it's got little Christmas things on. But I like the red. I helped her pick them out. And this is kind of your traditional sort of print with, like, you know, your deers and things on. So I really like it. And it's really, really cosy. I always get pyjamas for Christmas Eve for Santa coming. Because you've got to have new pyjamas for Santa. Right, so we'll move on to the non-makeup items. Right, so Tony got me some Pretty Little Liars stuff because I love the books. I don't mention it loads, but I have mentioned it a few times. And she got me books 13 and 14. I won 15 and 16, that's the last two in the series. But they're only out in hardback and I don't want hardback because all of the books that I've got are in softback. There are 16 books in the whole range, and then there's two other books that go along with the series. One that goes in between two of the books, which I'm yet to read because I purchased it after I'd already gone three books past that point, so I'll revisit that and it won't make a difference. And then the other book is the one actually that is A's book, and it's about A herself, it's about Alison. So I kind of want to read that at the end. I don't think it'll spoil anything, but I just want to read that after. So yeah, I don't know if that makes any sense, but it does for me. So yes, so I still need two of the books, but Tony got me these two, which are 13 and 14. So this one is Crushed and this one is Deadly. And it just happens that I'm up to book 12 and that's the last one on the shelf that I had. And then I got these two for Christmas. So now I'll be able to finish that book off. I've kind of been getting on with it a little bit slower, not wanting to read too much of it because I know it's going to come to an end and I'm going to have nothing to move on to. Well, nothing Pretty Little Liars anywhere to move on to. So I wanted more books before I kind of plodded on with that, but now I can because I have these two to get on to. And I absolutely love these books. I know they're a teenage thing, but it's really the mystery. It's like, who is A and all these things that happen to them. And I really love the four central characters. I do want to do kind of like a series of videos, if anybody be interested on that, which is kind of doing the makeup for each girl and then a lookbook for each girl because they all dress differently. So I think I might do that at some point because I really love Pretty Little Liars. So she got me those, and they're actually, these are like, they're really cheap on Amazon and on Play. Amazon I think is the cheapest. They're only like £2.80 each or something, which is actually really, really good because I know they're normally around £5 in Smiths. And then another thing that she got me, and it is Pretty Little Liars season 3. Now, if you were watching this on MTV in the UK, we got to the end of season 2. In fact, I'm not even sure that we got to the end of season 2. We got to season 2 and it was cancelled because there wasn't enough viewing, which is crazy to me because I love the series. Now, if you think, oh, well, but you're reading the books and will you get far ahead and will it be, you know, is it the same? The books are completely different. The Pretty Little Liars TV series is actually based on the books, so you have the same characters but not necessarily the same things are happening. In fact, it's completely different to what's happening in series 3, and there's a lot of things happening in it that actually never even happened in the books, so it's a very, very different to the books. And I really like how they take the characters in different directions in the TV series than they do in the books, so I find it really interesting. It's got 24 episodes on here, and we've watched 22. We watched them in the space of 3 days. Kind of, I've got Tawny into it because she wasn't actually watching it, but she came in and I was sitting watching this because Alec had gone to work, and she was like, "Oh, what are you watching?" So she's got into it, and we've just ended up where we watched, I think, about 7 episodes in a day. We were just like, it's really, really addictive because you want to know what's happening, and it's really, really exciting. I absolutely love it. And I've rewatched series 2 before I watched this because I've got series 1 and series 2 already, and I will definitely rewatch them again because I just love watching them. I think they're really entertaining, and I like this kind of thing, so I got that. And then another non-makeup item. This is a surprise that Alec got me. The most important thing is it's Batman related. I love Batman. Batman is my favourite character, animated character, film character. I just love Batman. I just think I quite like the dark gothic sort of side of things. And he got me this t-shirt, which says Catwoman. And basically on the front of here are all the different Catwomans that there have been, like in the animation. So, and I guess sort of the films really. So it's like all the different variations of Catwoman. And all the different outfits and kind of looks that she's had. I really, really love it. It's not huge though, and this is supposed to be an extra large. So it's probably going to be a bit tight at the moment, but I am losing weight. Yay, finally. Weight has started to move. So I do want to get into that. And I think this will just look amazing with jeans or like a nice little mini skirt and some tights and some boots and stuff. I really, really love it. So yeah, I've got nothing like that with Catwoman on, so I was really excited about that. And then we'll move on to something that is beauty but not makeup, because I think everything else is makeup from this point. And this is a perfume set. Yeah, so that's what this looks like. And I'm really excited because if you watch my videos, or if you've, you know, if you've browsed my past videos, one of my most watched videos, I think it's about, I don't know, it's between 11 or 15,000, I can't remember which one it is. I think it might be 15,000. Views is the Harajuku perfume collection video. It's one of my most viewed videos. I collect them. Found out that they'd released them in a new sort of version, and I think that this actually just smells the same as the original. And G is definitely my favorite, I think, out of the original. But out of the fuzzy headed ones, Baby's my favorite because it smells like Cabbage Patch Kid dolls. I just love the smell of it. This is just a gift set. And this perfume, I think, retails for £25 or £27, and you get the whole set for that price, and you get the extras, obviously. But this is the new style G bottle. Glass and square, so it looks like she's kind of standing on a plinth. So the perfume is 50ml, and she just looks like she's a white doll, and she's kind of been dipped in platinum, and it's dripped down her. And she's still got the same pretty sort of shape with the hair bow and everything on. And then the perfume is underneath in there. And it does smell the same. It actually has a slightly different smell than the original. But I can smell the coconut, and I love coconut smells. I've got like the body oil, the body spray, the hair stuff. I just love coconut. So that was definitely the one I wanted to go for. And it's really, really pretty. She's really big. I'm not sure if she's... I think she's bigger than what the original dolls were. Yeah, she is. She's a lot bigger than the original dolls. So yeah, she's exactly the same shape though, which I really, really liked. And I just thought that was quite different. In this set, I'm waffling far too much. You also got a body lotion, which is very exciting because I love the smell of this perfume. So, oh, it just smells divine. The idea of having a body lotion in the same as the perfume, I love that. I love my body lotion for Britney Spears Believe, which is my all-time favourite. You also get a cute little key ring of G, which is Gwen, because it's obviously Gwen Stefani's original perfume, so she is G. So I love that little key ring. I can't wait to put that on my keys. Moving on to makeup. Okay, so a couple of things. Well, I wrote a list, and Alec was really quite busy with work and stuff, so he didn't really have much of a chance to do much browsing, so he just kind of ordered some stuff off my list, which means I got a lot more makeup than I normally would, so I'm very excited. But the downside was I got this, and it's been sat there since it was released in October. I think it was released in October, and it's been sitting in the cupboard since October, and I haven't played with it. I've been so good, I haven't even swatched it. I did open it to check that nothing was shattered, because that's very important. I didn't want it to open at Christmas Day and be like, oh my god, I have had this like 3 months and it's shattered. So no, everything is fine with it. It's a new case, The old cases were like this, but it is the same size, so. But I don't care for the packaging, really. I really love the old packaging, but I like the plastic, I like the jeweled UD, and now it just says Vice on the front of it. I mean, it's okay packaging, I'm not being a morning mini, I like the packaging, just I think I like the packaging of the original one a lot better, and I like the way it opens. But yeah, this is magnetic still, and it has a lot stronger sort of hinge, so you can hold it upright. So if you want to do your makeup in the mirror, then you can do. I'm sure everybody has seen this already, so I won't linger on it too much, but these are the colours. I've actually used it. I've been kind of just trying to amuse myself and playing around with it. I have took the brush out already. I've used 1, 2, 3, and then I've used all of those ones. I have used this one and this one. I've gone the wrong way. I've used these three. And I think I've just used these two. So I've basically used almost everything in this palette. I do love it. I think the colours are beautiful in this palette. I do think it's probably the most wearable. The first one had some random bright colours in. The first one is absolutely my favourite, to be fair. The second one was very muted, so it wasn't quite so me, because I like bright colours. And I felt that the second one was just a bit meh, really. Then I got the limited edition one, which I absolutely love. I've been using it a lot. I feel like the formulation in that palette is better than those colours when they were in original palettes. If you do get your chance to get your hands on it, I can't speak, then it is worth picking up, because the formulation is so much better. And it's just nice to have some of those colours in the same place. But I do love the colours in this. They're supposed to be in families that you can use them like this. But to be fair, I've been like kind of mixing and matching between them. I wore this colour with this colour the other day, so that one, and they are amazing together. Yeah, so, and I, Christmas Day, I wore the jewel tones, so, which is not usually my colour family, and then yesterday I experimented with these ones. Really, really like it. Really love the colours. I think there's a lot of great variation in there. There's nothing that's too bright, and there's it's not too muddy, so it's nothing too neutral. You've got some nice pops of colour in there without them being too in your face. And there's some of these great sort of jewel tones that everybody's into. I'm not so into berry tones, so they're not quite for me, but I used them on Christmas Day and I thought they were quite nice, so it did quite surprise me. And then I feel like you've got some great smoky neutrals on the outer edges there. And this one I just love as a highlight. My brow, I'm like in an eye corner. So yeah, it's very, very nice, and I'm really pleased to have it in my collection because I'm a huge Urban Decay fan and I do love it. So I like that, and it does come with a pouch, which kind of is useless to me in a way, because I wouldn't store it in the pouch. I store it on the shelf with the others. They kind of look like books on the shelf. I like how it looks, but the pouch itself is very sturdy, so I definitely will use the pouch. I'll probably just pop it in my work bag and keep things in it. It's quite nice, so I do like it, but I don't really see the point of it, if you know what I mean. Sticking with Urban Decay, we might as well stick with palettes also. I got there, and I never remember the name. It's the Naked on the Run. I keep on wanting to call it the Naked on the Go palette. This is what the packaging looks like. I kept the packaging because Alec was like, why are you keeping the box? It's like, yes, because I need to show people what it looks like. And it's got the information on the back about the products. So you get 5 small shadows and 1 deluxe eyeshadow. You can use this eyeshadow excuse me, you can also use this eyeshadow as a highlighter, depending on your skin tone, but that is actually an eyeshadow, and it's called 50/50. Some people have been calling it so-so. I know Bunny did a video and she was like, so this is so-so. It's like, no, it's 50/50. But it's difficult to tell sometimes with the packaging what things are meant to say. Anyway, you get a contour and bronzer sort of colour and your blush. Then you get a neutral lip gloss, which I'm not sure if I'm keeping because it's not so much my colour. But then again, Vinny did it in a Get Ready With Me video and it looked so beautiful on her. So I might try it. And then you got a liner and a mascara. And the liner is like sort of more of a dark brownie sort of rack, so it's just a bit more gentle. So I would say that this is a lovely palette. It's more of like your softer everyday look, although that, you know, you could darken it up with the eyeshadows, but because the liner isn't a black, it's not stark, so it's actually just, it's really nice. It's quite a mellow sort of palette. So this is the packaging. Everything's rattling about. It's really quite chunky as a palette, but it is very pretty. And the lid is really good, the hinge on it's really good, so it doesn't like flip back. You can actually use that, and you could use it to put your makeup on, which is really good. And then this is what it looks like inside without dropping everything out. I'm sure you've seen it a lot on YouTube already. So you get your gloss, which is in Sesso. I'm not too sure about the colour as yet, but when, as I said, when I saw it on Vinny, I thought it looked great. And this is full size, and I think it's about £14-16, I'm not entirely sure, don't quote me on that, but that's really good full size gloss. Then you get a deluxe sample of the Perversion mascara, which I'm looking forward to trying. I love trying new mascaras. I probably wouldn't necessarily, I've tried other Urban Decay mascaras that have come free with something and I've never been mega impressed. They're nice mascaras, I don't think they're anything special, but I definitely give that a go. And then you get a liner in Stag. Now the packaging will always tell you sort of the finish of it. So it's got a gloss to it, so it's not like a matte liner. And that's what that looks like. But it's a very dark brown. It's almost a black brown. Really, really pretty. I really love how dark that is and how dramatic. But it's not the next step, which is like the black, which is really intense. So you can actually have a slightly softer look to your eyes with this. So I really, really like that. And that's new, so I don't have that full size. Really excited to try that. And then in the palette. So this is what you get. I will do quick swatches because I am going to do a chatty get ready with me video with this, which I'm really excited to do. So you get 5 normal size shadows, which is like a general sort of size. Then you get the deluxe eyeshadow there, which is kind of what they've nicked sort of from Too Faced, where they did in the chocolate bar palette, where you got 2 deluxe shadows. This is a deluxe size. And then your contour and your blush. So that is the contour and that is the blush. I do think the contour does have a little bit of oranginess to it. I think, in fairness, it depends on your skin tone, and because I'm quite pale, it tends to come up that way. It's probably going to be more suitable for me to use, like, as a bronzer more, I don't know, up on my temples and stuff, and not quite so much there. Because I'd prefer to go for something a bit more sort of taupey sort of colour there, more ashy sort of grey-brown, so it doesn't look like a big orange streak on your face. But that's what those two colours look like, and the blush is really, really pretty. The bronzer, it just says bronzer and blush. That is super helpful, Urban Decay. Thank you very much. So starting from this end, you've got Dive, Fix, Resist. Then you've got Dare and Stun. Dive, Fix, Resist. Pretty, very pretty colours. That's just one swipe. So Dive is a coppery colour, Fix is kind of a very pale muted sort of taupe colour, very light brown, and Resist, which is a kind of sparkly mid-tone sort of brown. And then you've got Dare and Stun, which are, that's Dare and that is Stun. So that one is Dare, which is more of a matte darker brown, and Stun, which is a bronzy sort of colour, bronzy brown. And then you've got 50-50 at the bottom, which I'm really excited to kind of show and sort of swatch. That's 50-50, which is the deluxe eyeshadow, because I think I'd quite like to use it as a highlight. Let me see, I'm going to try and swatch it somewhere where you can see it. Yeah, it's very light on me. Oh, it's just so pale, it's ridiculous. But it does have like a sort of nice ivory glow. I mean, I like that kind of colour to use as a base for my other shadows to go on, but it'll also be really nice on the brow as a highlight and on in the inner eye corner. And I will do a get ready with me sort of chatty video, if you like, with this one, because I think this will be quite interesting. And Vinny did a lovely look with this one on her channel, so I might give that a go. I do love these chatty get ready with me videos, and I think I'm going to try and do more of them, because not many people tend to watch my tutorials because they obviously think I'm not very good. So maybe a chatty video is more the way to go. Plus I think you can just chat about what you're feeling about the products as you're using them, which I always think is really interesting. Sticking with Urban Decay, because I've got one more item from Urban Decay to show you. Alec also got me the Urban Decay Naked Illuminated. So this is Aura. It comes with a brush in the bottom, which I might use, I probably won't. And that is what the powder looks like. So it's just kind of a peachy colour. I have had a little bit of a play with it. And it's got a bit of gold overspray to it. Can you see it there? Kind of glowy here. really, really pretty. So, but the gold overspray goes, because I actually tested this out in store and the gold always frightened me, but when I was using the one in store that had been literally swiped a million times, it was just the most beautiful soft peach glow, which I really, really like. So he got me that. And then another highlighter that he got me is actually from Clinique, and it was from their winter collection. It's from their, I think it was called the Nutcracker collection. The blended face powder comes with a brush and it's in Snowflake Dreams. I actually saw this on Tara Baby's channel and it was like, right, that's going on my list. And I actually knew I was getting this. And I'll tell you that story in a second. But it comes with this sort of brush that you twist up to use with it. So that's quite nice for travel to put blush and stuff on. And look at the size of that. It's just such a great size. That's what it looks like. I really, really wanted a pink highlighter that had some colour, because I'm so into those dolly pink cheeks at the moment. I think they look so pretty. Like, almost like you just got a little bit of a flush to your face. That's some product. And it's got, like, quite a nice shimmer to it when Tara showed it. And some nice colour payoff. And I just thought, wow, I really love that. That's it there. And it's just such a beautiful soft pink sort of glow. I really, really love it. So I told him about it and I was like, right, get this, but get it off the Clinique site, because it's free delivery on the Clinique site. I'm signed up to the Clinique site because I do use Clinique products. Not loads of them, but I use them. And they were doing a 12 days of Christmas, so I'd already had an email kind of indicating, oh, it's free delivery and there's a different sort of treat every day. So he went on and he actually came and got me and he was like, right, okay, so there is a treat on today, but I really need you to actually come and help me, because obviously I don't want you to like be ordering your own presents, but you got 5 deluxe samples for free and there was a list to pick from, and he didn't just want to pick things and me not know what they are and kind of just been randomly picking them. There was one that he already had put in the basket that he knew I would like, because I always get it when it's free with magazines. So the one that he had put in the basket already was the mascara, and it's the High Impact Mascara, and it's a great size. I love this mascara. It's amazeballs. I'm not going to open it. It's just a standard kind of wand anyway. And put that in the drawer and keep that for when I need to get my next mascara. I only have around 3 on the go at any one time. So, I also got, I think it was the Intense Night Cream. I got a pot of that, but I've actually gotten that in the bedroom because I've started to use it, because I had a pot before and ran out. But the other samples that I've got, and I'm actually using this one, so this is a bit squidged. I got the Clinique 7-Day Scrub Cream. Again, I've had this before in sample format. I don't use it 7 days. I just kind of use it like once a week, but it's a really great scrub cream. And it's such a great size. I mean, you know, that's a huge size really for freebie. I also got the Repair Wear Laser Focus. This is Smooths, Restores, Corrects. And it's for all skin types. That's the size of that one, which is really great. I love Clinique skincare. It's just amazing. And then the last thing that I got, which is, I think it's reasonably new, is the Clinique Smart Custom Repair Serum. I love skin serum, so I was very excited to see this was one of the options. And you do get a really generous sample size. That's my hand. That's the sample size. Very, very impressed. The last things I've got to show you are from MAC. So I love paint pots. Always store them upside down to keep them moist. So I did get a paint pot, but I also got some backup products. So I'm not going to show you the backups. I'm going to show you the ones that I've already got, but just to prove that I'm not just showing you an empty box. So this is the Sharon Osborne collection, and it is the pencil sort of lip product. And this is, I think, is it called a lip polish? The Patent Polish Lip Pencil. So that's that, and I love this. Let me show you mine. This is mine. It's very grubby looking because I absolutely love it. And it's an amazing colour. It's bordering a pinky lilac. That's it there. I love this colour. It's so beautiful and amazing. And I sometimes top it on top of Dodgy Girl. And I absolutely love it. And I was like, I was on Selfridges and they had it. And I was like, oh my goodness, I wanted a backup of this. I couldn't get it. It's sold out. I really, really need to get this. So I put that on my list and he got me that. And then this is something that he kind of got me that I didn't know about, but my reaction to the one that I got, I got it at the same time, I think, off Selfridges. And it is the Sparks of Romance, which is from the winter collection. So that's what that looks like. It's an amazing red. So it got me a backup of that because I have been so obsessed. There it is. So that's it there. amazing red, got a little bit of sparkle to it. It's quite blue base, which I really like, but it's bright. So I love that, and he got me a backup of that because he knew how much I loved it. And I was like, oh, I don't want to wear this too much, but I do want to wear it a lot. So, yes. And then the last thing, oh no, there's two more things, but I'll show you the paint pot that I got. So this is a paint pot in camel coat, which I've had my eye on for ages, and I just put it on my list. I still want Stormy Pink, which was another one that was on my list, and possibly Taylor Grey, but this was high on my list. I kind of like indicated things that were more favourites because I didn't expect them to buy everything on my list, but that's what this one looks like. And I love it, but I wanted to show you it alongside Paintly, which is what Tony got me last year. You'll see they're quite similar. So that's Paintly, which you can barely see because it's like very much my skin tone. And it's actually what I use as an eye base for looks, and I absolutely love it as an eye base. I really like it on its own sometimes as well. So I really, really love that. But I wanted to get Camel Coat, and it's really exciting to finally be able to swatch it. That's what that one looks like. And it's actually more cool tone than Paintly and darker. So Paintly's here, and that's Camel Coat. And it's really, really pretty. Very excited. Because I like that kind of colour. I like that kind of colour. Sometimes I just want that colour all over my lids if I'm in a bit of a hurry. So I really, really wanted that. So that is exciting to me. And then the last thing that I've got to show you is actually from the Heirloom collection. Not the Heirloom mix. It's the MAC Holiday collection. And it's the Keepsakes. And it comes in this amazing box with this cameo sort of lady on the top. Now, I've actually took the interior out, but I haven't started using it yet. But this is actually plastic, so it's not cardboard, which is really good. It says MAC on the front. So I'm going to show you the pigments that came in that. This is the Objects of Affection Silver and Blue Pigments and Glitter Set. So the first one is called just White. That's what it looks like. So it's super, super pigmented. I don't keep these little things that they put over the lid. That's what that one looks like. I don't like them because I just find fiddling with these is just a worry. Yeah, that's the pearlescent white, which I really, really wanted to try because I really wanted to use this on brow bone and inner eye. I think that says blue noir. I haven't even opened these until I did this video because I was like, no, no, I will not open these till I do my video and I can show you. Look, let me see if I can just get my pinky in there. Now that's just the slightest little hint of it because I can't really get my finger in. Ooh. When I move my hand, look at that. It's a beautiful, very dark, smoky sort of blue, and it's almost got like a teal on the surface. Ooh, it's so pretty. Oh, I think this is dark blue green. That's what that one looks like. This is so beautiful. I think this is part of the permanent range, this one. I'm not sure. Look at that. Oh, it's so gorgeous. Okay, this one's the pigment. I've dropped the lid again, but never mind. So that's what that one looks like. Which kind of looks almost black. But it's actually just a very intense navy, and I love the shimmer in that one. Those are the kind of pigments I really love that have got a bit of shimmer. And then this is the grey glitter. Okay, so I've dabbed some on the back of my hand, but I'm not going to be able to show you massively. So hopefully you can see in there, just like a dark grey slate, grey sort of glitter. And that's what it looks like on my hand, which I am so excited about this one. I know it says not for use on eyes, but like I said, use your own discretion. I will use up my eyes with my lit glitter glue. It'd be really great as a line and colour, really, really pretty. So very excited about those. And then the last thing to show you is just a lipstick. Alec was like, I want to get you like a limited edition lipstick. And I was like, well, they're sold out now though. And he was like, oh, well, you know, I wanted to get you something different. So I just kind of went and had a look and I picked out a mineralized lipstick. So that's what the packaging's like. They don't go in my little stands. Too wide on the bottom. Never mind. But yes, I wanted to try one of these because I wanted to try one of these mineralized ones for a while. They're called the Mineralized Rich Lipsticks. So I just gave him a couple of colors in this range and he picked out this one, which is called Divine Choice. And I have used it, I wore it on Christmas Day. And it's so beautiful. It's just a gorgeous, gorgeous pink colour. And that's it there. So pretty. I really, really love it. So, that is it. That is everything I got for Christmas. It's quite a mishmash of stuff there. I'm really, really pleased with everything I got though. I'm very grateful. And yes, I'm not bargaining anywhere. You did get a lot of bargains on some of these things, so yes. And I did help him out with my Debenhams points as well, so yes. I'm very excited about the presents I got. I think I got a really nice mix of things, and I love everything. So anyway, that's it. If you got anything that I got for Christmas, then please do comment below. But comment below anyway. I love comments and I love to interact with everybody. So don't forget to like, comment and comment. Did I say that properly? Don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe as always. I'm going to love and leave you there and see you all soon. I've been Spacey's number one girl and this is the colour of my kiss.